Happy Monday, everyone. I'm Stan the Medical Minuteman, and I'm back with your weekly Medical Minute. This week, we'll be discussing food poisoning and E. coli 0157H7. Food poisoning, also called foodborne illness, is any illness caused by eating food contaminated with infectious organisms or toxins, but I'll be focusing on food poisoning caused explicitly by E. coli 0157H7. The CDC monitors and reports multi-state E. coli outbreaks. This year, the CDC has reported two outbreaks related to E. coli 0157H7. Both of this year's outbreaks were due to contaminated romaine lettuce, but that's not the only source of infection. Looking back through CDC's reports, you'll see ground beef, flour, alfalfa, chicken salad, and even frozen food products. It's important to understand that this issue isn't related to a specific food type. It's a result of cross-contamination during one or more stages of food processing. In the instance of romaine lettuce, the source of E. coli is thought to be manure. This is because E. coli is shed during defecation. With supply chains reaching across the country and the world, contamination in one area can have far-reaching effects. There are many strains of E. coli, and each strain is referred to as a serotype. E. coli isn't inherently dangerous. In fact, E. coli resides in the intestines of nearly all humans and animals. It's an integral part of a healthy intestinal tract. Of the E. coli serotypes that are harmful, most cause brief stomach cramping and diarrhea, lasting 24 to 48 hours. E. coli 0157H7 is a particularly nasty serotype that belongs to a group of Shiga toxin-producing E. coli. Shiga toxin is one of the most potent bacterial toxins, and it inhibits protein synthesis. E. coli 0157H7 infections often cause severe hemorrhagic diarrhea and abdominal cramps. The most important treatment is fluid replacement and blood pressure support, as days of severe diarrhea can quickly lead to life-threatening dehydration. Immunocompromised individuals, children, and elderly infected with E. coli 0157H7 are at an increased risk for hemolytic uremic syndrome, known as HUS. HUS involves the destruction of red blood cells and kidney failure. It affects about 2-7% of those infected with E. coli 0157H7. In the United States, HUS is the leading cause of acute kidney failure in children, and most cases are caused by this E. coli serotype. In the case of HUS, fluid replacement may not be enough. In many cases, blood transfusions and kidney dialysis are necessary. While E. coli is a bacteria, the use of antibiotics in the treatment of E. coli 0157H7 can increase the risk of developing HUS, and therefore is often not recommended. One theory is that the rapid death of E. coli accelerates the release of the Shiga toxin. Interestingly, anti-diarrheal medications are also not recommended as they slow the digestive system and therefore the expulsion of the bacteria. Confirming a diagnosis of E. coli 0157H7 food poisoning relies primarily on detecting the bacteria present in a stool specimen. Prevention involves good hygiene and food safety practices. Cooking meats well, washing vegetables before eating them, avoiding unpasteurized milk and juices, and avoiding cross-contamination when preparing food are all good practices that are recommended by the CDC. I hope that you've enjoyed this week's Medical Minute featuring food poisoning and E. coli 0157H7. Please join me next week for a review of antipyretics. And for more updates like these, come join us online.